Let's get started with one of the first questions of the day. I believe you have a question to ask.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
My name is Jessica. My question is regarding communication skills. That is not about English. My question is that what we can do best for our interviews.
How to develop the best communication skills to succeed in interviews is your precise question.
Yes.
And your name is?
Jaskiran.
Jaskiran. Thank you so much, Jaskiran. Please take a seat.
Thank you. In fact,
the last video that we did on communication skills at the first Coach on Campus program, Mr. Lavi Chauhan became an internet sensation for asking this question. And I think in that video, I made it amply clear that language and communication skills are two entirely different things. The ability to know a language and the ability to communicate are two very different things. You can know a language and still not be able to communicate, right? And you perhaps don't know any language at all. You can still communicate using your body language. So these are two different things. But now today, your specific question is, how do I develop my communication skills to succeed in interviews? Crack the interviews of the best hotel chains, management training programs, cruise liners, and other sort of exciting opportunities, right?
Yes.
So I have an in-depth answer prepared to assist you with that today. Communication skills for job interviews. Number one, authenticity. Number one is?
Authenticity.
What does authenticity mean? Being authentic means?
Be yourself.
Be real. Don't be someone else. An interview is not an exam that you can prepare for 5 days before, mug up some lines. Somebody told you how to prepare for an interview. The first question is going to be, tell us about yourself. My name is, I'm a student. And the interviewer is saying, stop. No. But sir, I have to finish. I have to complete what I memorized. This is the problem with being a tape recorder. If you will memorize things, you're stuck. An interview is not an exam. Get this?
Yes.
Exams you can succeed at. Take last 5 year papers. Don't sleep at night. Just mug up everything, right? And then just go out in the examination hall and vomit. Not like physically vomit. Mentally vomit.
Mentally.
Right? You put it here, you were overfeeding your brain in the last 5 days and now you vomit on the sheet. And then, you know, wow, you succeed, you do well. Interviews don't work like that. Interviews, they want to know who you are. Would you be a right fit for their culture? Would you be a right fit for their hotel? Do you have the right skills they want for their in their team? And they're going to ask you questions, open-ended questions like, tell us about yourself. They want to know about you as an individual. Don't go with factual information. My name is so-and-so. I study at GNA University. Hello. He saw the board outside. The interviewer checked, I have to go to GNA University today. He looked at it so many times and now you're telling him the same information. Right? Don't tell them the obvious. They want to know you. And it's very important in the process of knowing you that you be authentic, which means you be original. You be yourself. Now, a video went viral on the internet about attitude is the king. No, he went into the interview with tattoos and so many other things. You saw that, yeah?
Yes.
And please don't follow that advice, right?
Yes.
Because interviewers have multiple choices. There are 60 students in this one institute and there are like 100 institutes there. If you don't come across as somebody that they like for their culture, they're going to go somewhere else. But at the same time, I'm asking you not to be fake. I'm asking you to be authentic. It's not an act that you can prepare for 5 days before. It's about a representation of who you are. An interview is a representation of who you are, accurate representation. So be yourself. It's not an exam. Don't mug up answers. That's really, really important. Try to know what the interviewer might ask you about, but don't memorize. Problem with memorization is you forget one word and the whole train stops.
Yes.
You were like a Shatabdi Express when you started your answer. Because you've rehearsed it 100 times, right? Then what happened? You forgot one line. And the whole thing is like, you're blank now. stuck, right? But if you're speaking from the heart, if you're speaking from experience, if you're actually telling them about yourself, even if you get stuck, you can recover. Yes. You can start on the next thing. Sir, I participated in the dance competition. I used to participate in the chef's competition. I'm an active sports person. This is what I do apart from. I did my internship with this hotel company. This is what I learned during my internship, etc., etc. If you're speaking from experience, then you have no problem. But if you've mugged up the answers, you're going to sound scripted, right? You're going to sound artificial. You know how much we hate listening to someone who's sounding artificial? You know that?
Yes.
Ever seen the some of the fitness ads on how to get six packs? I have a one pack, so I. But a six pack, you know, the people there who sell these equipment, ab exercise equipment, no, those yes. ads are short in the US, right? And they have American models. But when they're dubbed in Hindi,
yes.
You seen those?
Yes.
Aren't they hilarious? Right? Many ab exercises abhi kuch mahine pehle khareeda aur dekhiye meri abs. It's like you're laughing off because they're giving you the right information. Yes or no?
Yes.
But what's funny in that thing? It's not
authentic.
Your brain is not accepting this information. Yes. Here, someone is a two-piece bikini with a six-pack. Talking Hindi, right? Not that somebody in a bikini cannot speak Hindi, yeah. But what you're seeing, the visual and that thing is not connecting. It's scripted. It's sounding not natural and your brain is rejecting it, right? Yes. So you have to understand now some youngsters, what they do, they make this mistake. They go on to, they watch too much of Netflix. They watch too much of Game of Thrones. G-O-T, right? I haven't watched a single episode. People like me exist, right? But anyway, so you go on and watch a lot of the other stuff and then you put on some of the way how they speak. That's a very dangerous thing to do, right? And then you go into your interview talking like that. And that's even more dangerous. So be yourself, be authentic, be comfortable, be relaxed, right? Always, I suggest always put both your feet flat on the ground. Don't be moving your legs up and down like this. Put your hands comfortably on your knees or on your thighs. Be comfortable. Breathe a lot, right? And be at ease. It's not, if you fail, you're not going to be convicted or sent to jail or imprisoned for the rest of your life, right? It's just you want to be your best natural self. Body language. What's your body language right now? Look around you. If you run a restaurant, who would you hire? If you run a five-star hotel, who would you hire? Look around at your classmates. Who would you hire and who would you not hire? How important is body language? What does this convey about me? What does it say about me?
Tired, lazy.
I'm not, but I just like it. What is this? Some people, they drag their shoes while they walk. This is the latest thing. Yeah? What does this say about me? I can't lift my own feet. You know, I can't lift your tray of champagne or do something else, right? Posture, facial expressions, tone of voice, right? All these simple things. I'm not saying wear Hugo Boss or Armani or some of those brands, but be comfortable with yourself. Be at ease with yourself, right? In the hotel industry, it's always showtime. Don't forget that. Be at ease, breathe more often during the interviews. Don't go in there like Baba Ramdev in the yoga session. What I mean by breathe more often is breathe fully. Don't do shallow breathing. Breathe fully so that you're comfortable, that you're not nervous before you start answering the questions. Postures reflect energy levels. Hello? Let us repeat this.
Postures reflect energy levels.
How you're sitting in a chair, for example, is going to say a lot about your energy level. Do you want energetic people in the hotel industry or not energetic people?
Energetic.
Right? So think that you run a hotel, what sort of a person will you hire? Simple as that. Be that person. If you've spent $100 million on building a five-star property, I want to go recruit staff members. Imagine you have spent your father's money you've put in. What sort of people will you look for? Be that person. Simple trick. Be that person. So we've talked about authenticity, yes?
Yes.
We've talked about body language. Your body language speaks before you do. And after that, your tone of voice speaks more than you do. Some people say, I'm a nice person. I never say something wrong to anyone. I don't know why I end up having a fight with everybody. I don't know why everybody thinks I'm angry all the time. Everybody comes to me after 10 minutes saying, are you okay? Are you angry at something? Are you mad at something? I'm like, no! Then it's probably something to do with your facial expression, right? Tone of voice can change the meaning of a sentence. Yes or no?
Yes.
You can have one of your friends, you wear a nice new shirt one morning. You can have one of your friends coming up to you say, that's a nice shirt. Compliment?
Yes.
You have another friend coming up to you say, that's a nice shirt. I've changed the tempo, the tonality and the facial expression. The words remain the same. Yes or no?
Yes.
I'll now take it as an insult. Right, what's wrong with my shirt?
Yes.
Right, suddenly. So these are things. I learned how to say please a very hard way when I was a young student in Australia. I needed cash. I needed change. Right. So I took a $20 bill to the cashier at one of the supermarkets. And like here in India, we usually order change. Yes.
Yes.
Change. Give me some change. Right. So I like, I need some change. And she said, of course you need some change. That's why you're here. She said, there is a magic word which opens the till. I said, which one?
Please.
There were 20 people standing behind me. I never felt more insulted. I said, please. I said, okay, can I have some change, please? Ding! She presses the button, the drawer opens, she gives me the change. Just that simple word made a whole lot of difference. So these simple things, small is equal to big. Please remember that. What is?
Small things
can have a big impact. Do you put your chair back into place after you walk away from the table? Right? Are you banging the door as you move along? And simple things like that. Some people bring with them these plastic bags. And to take out their documents, they're like taking 15 minutes. And all this noise is coming from the plastic bags and they're not able to figure out what document the interviewer needs. Interviewer doesn't have whole day. He has 60 other students to meet. Be quick, please. Every small thing is saying big things about you, about your preparation, about what sort of an employee you will be. Next is do your research. Please, everybody say out loud, I will do my research. How many of you did your research before coming on Coach on Campus program? Raise your hands. Did you watch the last videos?
Yes.
Do you know what this is about? Yes. So don't end up anywhere blank. It's very dangerous. Ending up somewhere completely blank. You don't know what's happening there. You could be in the wrong place, right? It is very, very important for you to know, why am I here? In that interview, who are these people? What are they looking for? What are their corporate values? What am I bringing to the table? How many hotels do they have? Where did this company start? How long ago this company? Do some general research, please. Look at their website. Go to YouTube, watch some videos. Listen to their chief executive talking about their values. Do something. There's plenty of information available now. More information in one day you are getting on your smartphones than our grandparents got in their entire life through your WhatsApp. Now a lot of people are blaming, how do I remain focused in my life? Right? So you're getting, there is no shortage of information, but do your research, please. Read up about the company. Know the positions they are hiring for. It's really, really important. Because you may not fit in into one of the positions in the interview, but you can always talk about something else. If you've seen the list, right? Have that conversation. You can only have that conversation if you know, if you've done your research. Some of the turnoffs that you should avoid, that you will turn the interviewer off, arrogance, number one. Cockiness. I'm going to go into the interview room to prove, tell this fellow, you're nothing. You've come here and now you're going to see what hotel management students are about. And I'm going to prove him that. Nobody likes arrogance or cockiness.
Yes.
Being at ease with yourself, self-assurance, those are good qualities. In the service industry, arrogance, you're trying to make a statement about your attitude through something like that, you're on the wrong path. And at the same time, desperation, also very dangerous. So please, nobody's hired me. 20 companies came, nobody liked me. You please give me a job, right? Desperation is dangerous, arrogance is dangerous. You be in the middle, which means you're open, you're receptive, but you're confident and you're at ease with yourself. Carelessness at the same time. Some people think, carelessness is a statement about how cool they are, right?
Yes.
Oh, you didn't bring that? No, it's okay. I forgot. It's okay. I'll go get it now, sir. No problem. Hey, you're making a statement about what a cool guy you are, what a cool girl you are. You're not. You're showing that you're careless. And that's it. You go into an interview and they expect you to be clean shaven. If you're clean shaven, they expect you to be clean shaven. You don't shave for 2 days, you go walk up. And that's a statement that you're making, that you're careless. If you don't care about yourself, you're not going to care about the company.
Yes.
You're not going to care about their customers, about their employees, and they don't want you. Nobody wants you in that sort of scenario, right? Asking irrelevant questions is a big, big turnoff. Sir, when will I get the next promotion? Or when will I get the next pay hike? The guy's thinking, I even haven't even selected you yet. You even haven't proven yourself so far. You've not even proven yourself so far. You've not even been selected, right? And don't sound it's all about money, money, money. Money is important, but if your entire 100 focus is about how much I'm gonna get paid, when I will get the next raise, focus more on development, less on the financial aspect. That's very, very important, especially in your first few jobs. Look more for opportunities that will develop you into something good. The money will come, I assure you. Build yourself up first, and then let the money follow as you go along. This is about keeping certain things in mind, certain mistakes, certain pitfalls that we have to keep in mind. Again, the next very important thing about succeeding in an interview is listen. Everybody take a deep breath in once again. I will listen before I start speaking. Say it out loud, please.
I will listen before I start speaking.
Understand before you start. Sometimes we haven't even understood the question and we've already memorized one. And you're thinking, golden opportunity. I had memorized that answer. This is the time to fit it in. Let's fit it in. We don't do it in interviews. Yeah, if you become a politician tomorrow, you do it. Mm. Politicians, they do it very well.
Yes.
The news anchor is asking about something else. He will start about talking about something completely different. Sir, what happened to the promises you made last year? Mm-hmm. And he will start talking about, yes, India has a lot of tourism potential. News anchor is thinking, that was not my question, but they're good at this and they get away with this, but that is reserved only for politicians. For interviews, be specific, listen completely, and then start answering, and let the interviewer finish their sentence completely before you start answering. And be ready for follow-up questions, very, very important. The problem with memorization, I say again and again, tell us about yourself, you memorized 5 sentences, okay? You've rectified 5 sentences. And now he asks a follow-up question. So let's say you memorized, I was part of chef's competition somewhere. He's gonna ask you follow-up questions. Where did this happen? What did you cook? Did you win? Who won? What did you learn? And if your mind is blank at that point of time, you've lost it. He knows you're a tape recorder, and that's it. He will put you in a job worthy of a tape recorder. You want that job? Some of you are not sure. Do you want that job?
No.
Where you are only doing what you are told. That's not exciting. You want jobs where they trust you. You want jobs where they give you freedom to do. It's your restaurant, you run it the way you want. It's your kitchen, you run it the way you want. It's your cafe, you run it the way you want. But you have to demonstrate that ability that I'm able to do something like this, okay? One question I had from the students, which was about Skype interviews. How many of your seniors have ever done, is that a common thing now?
Yes.
Interviews happening over Skype,
yes.
Or FaceTime or some sort of video conferencing. One of the most important things, as with our video filming today, let's give a round of applause to the GNA team who put this together. The layout of this room, my friends, my viewers, and everybody who's watching, was done the night before. Actually, and I had already received the photographs that this is how the whole place is going to look like. Only hotel people can do this. Only hospitality people can look this far. They keep their things ready. So you please also do with your equipment before a Skype interview. Check the equipment. Do a demo call with one of your friends. Check if the sound is working okay. If the internet connection is not too slow. If the other person can hear you properly. Check if the lighting is okay. Right? if your face is being properly lit or not. Check if your posture is coming, is appearing right in the frame that you're sitting or not. If not, change it. If you want to keep a pillow underneath the chair, do that by all means, right? If you want to keep a small lamp on facing, the light facing on your face so that it is better lit, because what you see makes a huge impact, right? Yes. The interviewer is perhaps going to make a calculated risk. He's not there in person. He's sitting in Bangalore or Hyderabad or Kuala Lumpur or Singapore or wherever. He's going to make his judgment based on what he's seeing on Skype at that point of time. Every single thing is making a difference. So check your sound equipment, your video equipment, your lighting. Are you comfortable or not? How you look in the frame, etc., etc. All those things, right? Faulty equipment can lead you to missing out on some very important opportunities. So make sure your equipment, power backup, things like that, in case you have a power failure, check with your faculty member, whoever's coordinating, that all these things are in place. It is a win-win situation for everybody. You go grab that placement, it is a matter of pride for the institute and also for you, so everybody wins in that. When you're talking electronically, using Skype or other such medium, talk slowly than usual. Talk a little bit slower than usual, because sometimes there is a little delay over an internet connection of what you're speaking and what the other person is hearing. So talk a little bit slowly so that the other person can fully understand you. In case, you can always ask the interviewer, sir or ma'am or Mr. whoever, am I audible to you? What is the question we can ask?
Am I audible to you?
Can you hear me clearly? Can you see me clearly? Right, before you go on. So you don't want a situation where the connection has been lost and you are going on with your with your speech that you rehearsed. So you want to check that he or she is with you and is able to give pauses. Very, very important over a Skype interview. Give a pause. Sometimes we are afraid of silence, especially in an interview. How many of you are afraid of silence when you're talking to a stranger?
Yes.
So what you do out of fear is I will not stop talking. Because I don't like silence. So I'll go, yap. The person saying, give me a minute to think. But you don't like silence. Everybody say out loud, please. I will get comfortable with
silence.
Not too much though. You're getting too excited, rather. Oh, I don't want to be silent all the time in the interview. I will learn to give the right pauses at the right time, because we can speak at maybe 4 times faster than we can understand. You know this statistic? We can speak way faster than the mind can process. It's always very important. Slow a little bit down so that the other person is able to comprehend you, understand you fully. So far, so good?
Yes? Yes.
Thanks.